no church where his name is mentioned should be empty. Not as long as you in here. And you don't come just to sit and enjoy, but you must go when you come and then bring someone with you. Because you too got to be filled of men and women who are dying out in that world under Satan's grip. And the only way they can be free is you have to bring them to him who has been sent into the world to liberate us, not just from the oppressive hand of an oppressor, but to liberate us from the worst oppression of all, and that is sin itself. And so, my dear beloved brothers and sisters, as I leave you, I want us to think about how much we really love God. And I want you to think about how much we really love his true servant, the Christ. I want you to think now about what you have done to further his mission on earth, which is to preach the gospel. And if you're not a preacher, you got to bring the person to where the gospel is being preached, that they may hear the word and be transformed. If you bring them, you don't have to stay. But if you bring them to where the word is, you've done your job. But you and I should never come to the house of God by ourselves. Look at all the people in the street who don't have a spiritual home.
Thank you, God.
I know a stupid person. See, look at all of them out there. They don't go to no church. The men are not in the church, they're in the street. They're not in the mosque, they're in the street.
That's right.
Don't walk by the dope addict.
That's it.
Jesus wouldn't do it. No. If Jesus saw him, he'd stop. Brother, let me talk to you. Jesus would never walk by a prostitute. He would never hear the master say, "That old dirty thing, look at that out there." That's what he came for, to get her out of that mess. And that's why Mary Magdalene, who didn't have the best reputation, but Jesus knew he could make her something better than what the pimp made her, better than what her daddy made her, that he could make her what God intended for her to be. So he said, "Come unto me, all ye that are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Come unto me." And that's your work. As a Christian, and as a Muslim, you are always on a missionary assignment.
Always.
Listen, family. You say, "Well, yeah, but sure, if they bring them to the mosque, they ain't gonna be saved. They only saved in church." No. Mosque, church, pool room. See, we put too much stock in buildings and not enough stock in the word. See, it's not getting them in the church. Yes, get them here, but the idea is to get the church in them. Get the word in them. And wherever they go, God is walking with them. Wherever they go, Jesus is directing them. eye closed, knowing that life is like a vapor. It appears for a short time and then it vanishes. And so the time that you have and I have, we got to do something with our time to be worthy of the limitless time that God says he would grant those who accept eternal life. And so, family, I realize this is not the kind of subject matter that excites, but it excites thought. It excites introspection. It incites you to analyze not your neighbor, but yourself. And as you know, God has been good to every one of us that made it here this morning. God has been good to us. So you're not wrong to praise him. You're not wrong to love him. But you got to love him to the point where nothing else matters. That's it. That's it. You got to love him to the point where truth and the consequences of telling it, that's it, is more precious in your life, that's it, than all the honor that the people can bestow on you. And I say this as a man that is hated without a cause, as a man that is misunderstood because I am purposely misrepresented by those who fear truth, seeing their flake. They are afraid because they have us boxed in a sort of religiosity, but not in the mission of Jesus Christ or the mission of Muhammad. We have relegated these things to a back burner while we pursue the perishable goods of the world. God does not want you to be poor and ragged and hungry, naked and out of doors. And I don't serve no poor God. No. And I wouldn't follow him if he wanted to keep me in poverty. I'm already poor. I don't need God to keep me poor. So don't tell me Rockefeller is your father and you got holes in your shoes. If you tell me God is your father, then act like God is your father. If you tell me God is my father, then get up like a man that knows God is with him and start taking the world by the horns and wrestling the world down and overcoming the world, because greater is he that is in you. He that is in the world, do you love him? Do you love him with all your heart, soul, and mind? Then from this day forward, love ye one another, even as he has loved us. Practice loving those that you don't even want to love. Reach out for them, because the master came for all. To my dear pastor, may God, who has blessed you with 52 years of illustrious life, may God, who has blessed you with a saintly mother and a prophetic father, and touched her womb that you could be a believer from the womb, May God, who has grown you and nurtured you and protected you, and when the evil demon wanted to pull you down, they may have dispirited you for a moment, but in the stillness of the night, he let you know, Pastor Barry, that it's no easy road to come to him. He said, if you would be my disciple, some of you are going to be evil spoken of. You will be slandered. Some of you will be put in prison. And some of you will even be put to death for my name's sake. But overcome. And if you will hold on and overcome to you, I will give you the tree of life. I will give you riches and honor and glory. It all comes to the righteous. It will all come to the true Christian. It will all come to the true Muslim. So don't you worry about what the wicked has. Because theirs is only for a season. But if you will rejoice in the Lord, then yours will come. And when it comes, nobody will be able to take it away from you. For what God gives, no man can take away. Thank you, Pastor Barry, for the honor of being here with you today. Happy birthday.